Okay, the class is Analysis of Algorithms, Chapter 23, Minimum Spanning Tree. So Chapter 22 was basic elementary graph algorithms. Now we go on with more graph algorithms. Now I'm going to motivate minimum spanning tree when we get the definition of what a minimum spanning tree is. So let's wait off for a few minutes for that. And let's just start off with what is a minimum spanning tree. Three words. Okay. So first of all is as follows. Definition. A tree in a graph, okay, and usually the graphs are, well, I wouldn't say usually, directed or undirected, but, okay, a tree in a graph is a subgraph, in other words, it's part of the graph without cycles, okay. In other words, if this is a graph, okay, then the tree is something like this. Okay. Now, if I added this edge, there would be a cycle. If I added these two edges, there would be a cycle. There would be a way of going around. Okay. A cycle means like a circle. You'd be able to go around. Trees don't have cycles. Father, son, children, grandchildren, etc., brothers, sisters, but there's no intermingling. Okay, so that's the definition of a tree. Definition, a spanning tree is a tree that hits every vertex. Okay. In other words, spanning tree. It goes to every vertex. There's going to be some of the edges are going to be in the tree, but not all the edges. Maybe it could be all the edges, whatever. But that's not the point. But a spanning tree hits all the vertices, all the dots. Okay, good. So we now described this word and this word. Now we have to work on that word, minimum. What do I mean by minimum? Okay. Okay, we need room. Definition, a minimum spanning tree of a weighted graph okay. So it doesn't make sense to talk about a minimum tree, spanning tree of a graph. It has to be of a weighted graph because we need numbers. Now by weighted graph I mean the edges have numbers on them, positive numbers, usually positive whole numbers. Is a spanning tree whose weight is minimum. Okay, now by weight I mean the sum of all the edges, e member of the tree. Okay, now let me just say it another way, which is going to be more of a motivation. I.e., we can get to all the vertices in, so we can get all the vertices, meaning it's spanning, in the shortest amount of time. Cheapest price. Okay. The smallest mileage. Okay, so this is the motivation of what a spanning tree is. You have a bunch of cities you have to go to. You want some type of tree. Okay, here's the, well, I don't know, you have a bunch of cities here. Okay, and you have some type of tree that Karis, it's going to be your thing. And basically the idea is you want it to be a tree because you don't want any cycles here because it doesn't make sense. You want to get this to here. So should you go, let's say this was filled in, should you go through this or should you go through around like that? So you want one way to get to every single node. So that's why it's a tree. And also you want it to have the shortest price. Okay, let's do an example. Notice undirected. You can make similar definitions for directed. Okay, here's a tree. Now let's make it a weeded tree. Here's a weighted tree. I'd like to find a subgraph, a tree, that's in here that hits every single vertex, but it should have the minimum price. Obviously, it shouldn't contain this because that's a big number, and it shouldn't contain that because that's a big number. That's going to raise it a lot. But we'll have to see what it should contain. So I'm not going to tell you now how to find this. I just want to show you what the minimum spanning curve, and then we're going to do two algorithms that actually show you how to find it. So let's do it. No, let's not do it. Let's just give you the answer. And I'll show you how to find the answer in 1 minute. Okay. Every single edge is, every single vertex is hit. There is no cycle here. There's no cycle. And furthermore, what's the weight of this? Well, if you add up 1 plus 4 plus 5 plus 3 plus 9 plus 4 plus 2 plus 5, you get weight is 33. Now, you could find another tree. Well, anyways, this is the minimum. I know that for a fact. But you can find another tree of weight 33. Okay, but you're not going to find a tree of weight 32. Okay, so the minimum tree is not unique. Okay, it's not unique, but the weight is unique. In other words, you're not going to get something smaller than that. Okay, now to find it, we'll show in a second. But I would like to point out one thing dealing with a minimum spanning tree. Okay, the other thing I wanted to show is if you add any edge here, you will get a cycle. Let's just show it, okay? If I add this edge, then I can go around like that, okay? If I add this edge, then I can go around like this. If I add this edge, I can go around like this. If I add this edge, I can go around like this. If I add this edge, I can go around here. Any edge you add in, add this edge, you get the square. Any edge you add in, you would make a cycle. So you don't want to make any cycles. Okay? So what it is it's a tree where you add and add and add and add till you can't add anymore. Great. Okay, so now I want to do it. There are section 23.2 has two algorithms. Section 23.2 has two algorithms. One is called Kruskal's algorithm. You'll like that a lot. And one is called Prim's algorithm. They give you two ways of finding the tree. Prim's you will not like so much. So I want to do it, and I want to write the algorithm, and I want to do it together. Okay, so, but you don't have to watch me write. Okay, this is called Kruskal's algorithm. This is one way of finding a minimum spanning tree. But we have a little problem. The book does Kruskal's algorithm, but it assumes you did something in chapter 20, 21, something called dealing with discrete sets. I beg you to read that chapter. That chapter is something we did in data structures. I promise you, you'll use that chapter. We just don't have enough time to go through it ourselves. So it's dealing with, let's say I have, let's think of America. So you have 300 million people. So you want to think of them as split into different groups, New Jersey and New Yorkers, Montanans, et cetera, et cetera. So how do you, give me a data structure that deals with that and considers all people from Montana to be one set and all people from California to be one set. So that's called discrete sets. Now, we need that to do this algorithm. But I didn't have time to teach it. I've never taught it. And so I use a different algorithm, which is very, very similar to it. It's done the same way. Let me just tell you one second how discrete sets are done. Basically, for every element in your set of things, you have them pointing to one representative of that element. Okay? So all Montanans, people from Montana, will be pointing, there'll be a little pointer from every single person in Montana who's pointing to the representative of Montana. You might call the representative of Montana governor, okay? So they're all pointing to that. All the people from New Jersey will be pointing to their governor. All the people from New York will be pointing to their governor, okay? And then you can deal with, then any single person, you can figure out who they are. And more importantly, you're given two people, you want to see if they are belong to the same group, you see if they're both pointing to the same governor. If they are, then they're in the same group. If not, they're pointing to different groups. Okay? But there's other operations to deal with. For example, union two sets. How do you do that? Well, basically, one way of doing it is, in other words, if let's say New York and New Jersey decide to combine to become one state. How do you deal with that? Okay, so, God forbid. One way is take everybody in New York and point to New Jersey's governor. But there's another way also of doing it, and the book goes through it. We're going to have a similar type of issue, but we're not going to deal with it. Anyways, so what I did was I used an old version of the algorithm. Okay, and I think it's in the second edition or the first edition of this thing, and we deal with it like that. Okay, so the idea is very, very similar. Okay, so let's go through it. So it's the algorithm the book does is page 631, but you're going to have to read chapter 20 to understand how that data structure of discrete structures works. I'm not sure it's chapter 20 or 21 or something like that. Okay, let's go through it. MST Kruskal, that's the guy's name. MST stands for minimum spanning tree. You're given a graph and a weighted graph. Okay, so start off like this. What do you want? You want a tree. You want to know what is the tree that corresponds to. So start off, your tree is empty. Okay. Notice, here's an example, the tree is empty. Give each vertex a unique color, call it color V. Let me just read this because you don't have this in front of you. Let me read it to you and then we'll do it. Sort edges in non-decreasing order. Non-decreasing means increasing. Okay, but if you have two of them that are the same, it doesn't matter. Okay. For each edge E that's between U and V, this really should be curly brackets because this is an undirected graph. For each in order, in other words, we're doing this sorting, this is a greedy algorithm. This is the epitome of a greedy algorithm. We sort things and we grab it, knowing that we're going to get the right answer. Okay, for each edge, if the colors are not equal, we'll talk about these colors in a second, then add it to the tree. So the tree starts off as empty, but you can add it to the tree. And then you do something else. For each vertex T in the graph, if color of T is equal to color of U, or color of T is equal to color of V, then change the color. So if the T is equal, if the color T is equal to U or V, then change the color to the smaller, color of U or color of V. At the end, return A. Okay. Here's a nice example of the graph. Okay. We don't need our vertices to have names. That's not important to us. Okay. What they are going to have is colors. Okay, so let's do it. Okay. First thing first, the tree is empty. Okay, I'm going to shade in the elements of the tree. Give each vertex a unique color. I don't know names of colors very well, so I'm going to call them A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I. Okay. I'm going to give each vertex a letter. Okay? Okay, great. Sort edges in non-decreasing order. So let's go. This is going to be the first one. This is going to be second, third, fourth. There's a four. Oh, there's a third. There's a three over here. So sort them like that. Okay? And now let's go through it. So let's start with this. For each edge E in order, if color of U is not equal to color of V, these colors change, by the way, A is not equal to B, then look what we do. Okay, add the edge to the tree. So we're going to add this to the tree. Okay, and for each vertex T in the graph, if color of T is equal to U or V, if the color is equal to A or B, then change it to the smaller color U or V. Okay, so let's just do this. This is equal to A or B. It's equal to A, so change it to A. Well, that doesn't change anything because it was A. This is equal to A or B, and so we change it to the smaller one. What's smaller, A or B? Answer A. So we change this to A. Okay. I just want to say, at the end of this graph, at the end of this algorithm, all the vertices in the graph are going to have color A. Okay. That's what we're aiming for, and you'll see why in a second. Okay, next. Next thing is an edge of size of 2. We have 1, 2, 3 of size 2. Doesn't matter. We're going to choose. Let's choose this one. Now, you could choose other ones, okay, but you'll get different trees, but you won't get smaller than the number you're going to get here. Okay, so let's choose this one. F is not equal to I, so we add it in. And now we go through the entire graph, look for anything that's equal to either F or I, and change it to smaller F or I. So the only thing that's equal is this F and I. You're going to see why we made this in a second. So F or I, what's smaller? F. And so we're going to change this to F. That's F already. And we're going to change I to F. Okay. Again, eventually everything's going to change to I. Great. Okay, so we chose the 2. What else? Well, let's choose this. A or E. A is not equal to E, so we're going to choose this. Okay, this is in our tree. Okay, and we're going to change A and E, all the A's and E's to be A's. Okay, because that's the smaller one. Okay, now that's A already, so we're going to change this to A. Very good. Okay, great. Next, this is size 2. But let's go through it. This is A, and this is A. Bzzzt. You can't do that. Okay, this is A, and this is A. You can't do that. Okay, why can't you do that? Because if you added this in, you'd have a cycle. We're looking for a minimal spanning tree. No cycles allowed. So we can't have that. Okay, so we're not going to do that. Next, something of 3. Let's do 3. I'm going to choose this 3. So H and F, they're not equal, so we can add it in, okay? And what's smaller, H or F? Answer F. So we're going to change everything that's H or F, we're going to change to F. So that's F. This is F already. Okay. Okay, good. Next. What else do we have? Size 3. This is size 3. So let's add it in. Okay, let's add it in. I'm sorry. This is letter A and F. A and F are different, and so we can add it in. Okay, now what we're going to do is, for any node on the tree, for each node T in the graph, if you're either equal to A or F, change into the minimal, the smaller of A or F. Okay, well, A doesn't bother me. This is not A or F. This is not A or F. F. All three of these have to become A, the smaller of A and F. Okay, we're slowly getting everything to A. Notice there's no circuit here. Okay, great. So we did the 3. We did that 3. Okay, we have a 4 here. Let's do the 4. Buzz. D and G are not equal. We can add it in. So we add it in. What's smaller, D or G? Answer D. So we make this a D. Very good. Okay, we dealt with the 4. Now, let's deal with this 5s. There's a few 5s here. Let's deal with this 5 first. A and C. Bring it in. Change all the A's and the C's on this thing to A's. Well, the A's are already A's. Change that to an A. Okay. Notice we can't add this in because this is A and this is A. That would make us have a cycle. Okay, next. Okay, we're still in the middle of the 5s. We just did the 4. We did this 5. We have two more 5s to evaluate. A and A. I can't add this in. Watch what would happen if I would add this edge in. I would have a cycle. Can't add that in. But this 5 I can add in, so let's add it in. Bop, 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 bop. Let's just check that I can add it in. Here's A, here's D. They're different, therefore I can add it in. Now that I can add them in, I'm going to change anything in this graph, any vertex in the graph, which has a D or an A, into A. So the A's I don't mind, but the D's turn into A, and this D turns into an A. Am I finished? Are all the vertices A? Yes, all the vertices are A. I am now finished. Okay. Notice, add any vertex whatsoever, every single, let's just go through, every vertex is hit by the tree, okay? If I added any vertex whatsoever, if I added this vertex, we'd be able to go around. If I added this vertex, I'd be able to go all the way around. So these colors help keep track of what component you are in the tree. And the main point is, when you're uniting a tree, one part of a tree with another part of the tree, make sure that you don't unite them so that you hit, you don't want to make a cycle. So that's a very nice thing. Let's just sum up. Question. The weight here, if you add up, 1 plus 3 plus 2 plus 5 is 11, plus 4 is 11 plus 4 is 15, 20, 20, it's at 25. So the weight equals 25. Okay? You cannot do better than 25. Okay? Let's talk a little bit about the algorithm. Okay? Basically, for every edge here, you have to go through every vertex. So this part of the algorithm, this part of the algorithm, sorting, is, I should do this with a different color, I'm sorry. Okay, let's just do this with a different color, because now we're talking about analysis of algorithm, I don't want to mess this up. Okay, sorting, you're sorting the edges, so that's E times log of E. That's how much it takes to sort edges. And this is done as follows. For each edge, so that's the number of edges, okay? And what are you going to do for each edge? Well, you have here for each vertex. So number of edges times the number of vertices. That's how much work is done.
Okay.
That takes care of that. Key points. First of all, this is a greedy algorithm. We sort and then we grab what we can, and this tells us what we can grab and what we can't grab. Okay. The colors make sure that we don't get a cycle. Because here's the idea. If you have two things of the same color, then if you add in that edge, you're going to get a cycle. Don't want to get any cycles. Okay, so that's Kruskal's algorithm. It's nice, it's easy, it's fun. Now we're going to do Prim's algorithm. You don't have to watch this. Okay, so I want to go through the algorithm. This is the algorithm. It's on page 634. Now we do exactly the way the book does. I even did with the book's notation using OOP language. Let me just read it to you. MST, minimal spanning tree, Prim. Prim is somebody's name. He came up with the algorithm first. Given the graph, the weights of the graph, and R, we have a starting point here also. Okay. There we were just grabbing all over. Here we have a starting point, and we grow the tree from the starting point. You'll see what I mean in a second. For each vertex, set the distance, the key distance, how far you are from infinity, to be infinity. In other words, how far is every vertex from the tree? It's infinite away. Okay. U dot pi, the parent of every node is nil. Nobody's in the tree yet. Okay, this is just initializing. Okay. R dot key is equal to zero. R is going to be the first node that's in the tree. Okay. And then Q is going to be the set of vertices. We're going to make a Q of the set of vertices. Okay. And what we do here is, while Q is not equal to zero, slowly but surely we extract things from the Q. But until we finish extracting them, we don't. So whereas before we had in Kruskal's algorithm, we had A was empty, and we slowly fill it. Here, the Q starts out with all the nodes, and we slowly empty the Q. And when we finished emptying all the Q, which means we told every node what's the best way, then we do it. U equals the extract min of Q. For each vertex V adjacent to it, if V is a member of Q and da-da-da, we'll explain this later, then make this set. Let me give you intuition with this small thing. You're over here, okay, and you're growing this tree. This is your starting point, R, okay? Great. If I wanted to extend the tree to this point, and I'm only going to look at this point at this point, then what do I have to do? Well, I'm here, the tree is here. I would extend it, but I would add into that tree 16. I want to hit every single vertex. I want to hit this vertex. Well, right now I can hit the vertex with size 16. Very good. So I'm going to write the word 16. In other words, the distance from this vertex to the tree is 16. Great. Now, I'm going to grow the tree, but I'm not going to grow the tree here. I'm going to grow the tree here. Great. Now I am here. The tree is here. This whole thing is the tree. Question, what is the minimal distance that this node is from the tree? Well, it was 16, but you know what? Now it's 5. So forget about 16. I'm not going to use that node anymore. I'm going to try the 5. But I'm not done yet. Because now I'm going to grow this tree even more. And I'm going to grow the tree this way. Great. Now ask yourself the following question. What's the minimum way of this node to get to the tree? Well, we started off, it was 16. But then we found something better, it was 5. But now we got something even better, 3. Okay? And so it's going to be 3. We cross this off, we're going to get a 3. Okay? So this tree is minimal. Notice, 10 plus 4 plus 3 is 17. But anyways, I wasn't interested in the tree at the moment. I was interested in seeing what's the best way to pick up this node. And the answer is the best way to pick up this node is to wait and slowly grow the tree until you see everything. And that's exactly what's going on. Okay, I'd like to pick up a big example here and go through it. Okay, So here's a nice example. As you can tell, I don't have a lot of creativity with making up examples. It's exactly the same example before. I want to make sure that I get not the same tree, but the same number here. Okay? But the example is easy to use. However, here we have to keep in mind something like this. We're going to have to learn who the parent is. So I have to give names to the vertices. I must give names to the vertices so I can tell who's the parent of who. Okay? And by the way, these things are going to change. A vertices parent is going to change, just like we saw before. Okay, I wrote out my Q over here. The Q starts off, let's go through it. For each vertex, set the key to be infinity. I didn't write the key to be infinity, but basically it is. The parents are all nil. We're going to add in the nils when we see them. Okay, and start off R dot key. We're going to start off here. I'm going to write key equals zero. Okay. Q is equal to all the vertices. I put in all the vertices. While Q is not zero, while Q is not empty, let's do this. Extract minimum Q. Okay, well, all of them have infinite thing. The only thing that's not infinite is zero. So we choose this. Okay, so we could choose this. For each vertex G member of adjacency of U, now we're going to look at all the children of A. We're going to look at all the children of A. A has three children, okay? We're going to do them in alphabetical order, obviously. Let's go through it. If V is a member of Q, everything's a member of Q. Extract minimum. So I took out A because A has the smallest. So we took this out, okay? Let's go through it. If V is a member of Q, yes it is. Let's talk about B. If V is a member of Q, yes, it is. We're talking about B, the child B. And W, the weight from U to V, so the weight from A to B is 1, is less than V dot key. Okay? The key here was infinity. Now, question, is 1 less than infinity? Yes, it is. Okay? So what we're going to do is, maybe I should use a different color here. Maybe I should do it with a different color just to show it. What I'm going to do is, since 1, going from here, is less than infinity, it was infinity, okay? So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to make the parent here to equal to U. Parent is equal to A. That means A brought it in, okay? And the key is equal to 1. Great. Okay, next, we have to deal with the next child. He's the next child. The key was infinity. What's better, 7 or infinity? The answer is 7. Key equals 7. Parent equals A. Great. Now let's do E. E is also in there. B, D, and E are also in there. Let's look at E. The distance from this vertex to the tree was infinity. Now, what's better? 2 AE or infinity? The answer is 2. So let's do it. K equals 2, parent equals A. Okay, great. Okay, we now finished all its children. We are finished. Great. Now, look at all the things in the queue. Tell me, by the way, these have infinity as their key. These have infinity as a key. This has 1, 2, and 7. Okay, what's the smallest? Answer, 1. So I'm going to choose 1. Okay, so he is now in the tree. Okay, and by the way, this is never going to change. Once you choose it you've extracted it from the key, it's never going to change, which means that this thing is going to be in your tree because I've extracted it and his parent is A. Finished. Now, what are we going to do? We're going to look at the children of B. How many children does B have? 1, 2, 3. Okay? Let's do it in alphabetical order. C. Let's go through it. C is in the queue and the distance from U to V, from B to C, the distance from the thing we just extracted from the tree to the new vertex is 8, and this was infinity. What's better, 8 or infinity? Answer, 8. So key
is,
because we're looking for minimum,
the key equals 8. Okay. Parent equals B.
Okay. Okay, good. So this is in there. Very good. So we've visited this key. We dealt with this child. Now we're looking at more children of B. E is another child of B. Let's go through it. You ready? This is an important thing. E is still in the queue. Still in the queue. And the weight was 2. The best way to get to here was 2. But now we have a new one, which is also 2. Question, is the new weight 2 less than the old weight? No, it's not. They're equal. So it's not. So we're not going to adjust this. We're going to keep this as his parent. We're not going to adjust this. Let's do F. F's key was infinity. What's better, infinity or 3? Answer 3. So let's write it. K, 10. Key equals 3. Okay. Parent equals B. Okay. And I am now finished. Great. I went through all 3 of B's children that were not in the thing. He also is a child, technically, but he's not in there. Great. Now I extract the minimum. What's the smallest thing? Infinity, infinity, infinity. 3, 2, 7, 8. Okay. Which one should I extract? Answer, 2. So let's extract it. Okay. Who's the parent of 2? A. So I'm going to extract E, because that's the minimum. Who's the parent? A. Okay. He's in the tree. And now guess what I have to do? I look at all the children of E. How many children does E have? Almost everything is a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. He has 6 children. Okay, but let's go through them. This child is not in the queue. We don't talk about it. This child is not in the queue. We don't talk about it. This child is a potential. This child is a potential. This child is a potential. And this child is a potential. So let's do it. How are we going to do it? Which one first? He's not in the queue. He's not in the queue. We do D. D first. Okay, great. This is the most important one. This is how the algorithm works. This is the main part of the algorithm. You ready? Let's go through it. It used to be that the best way to get to the tree was 7. Okay, now we're looking at him. What's the best way to get to D? Answer, 6 is less than 7. 6, the weight from here to there, is less than 7. Conclusion, I'm going to cross this out. The key was 7, now the key is 6. The father, who's your father, who's your daddy? It was A, but now we're going to think of it as E. Okay, so that takes care of that. We've adjusted his closest distance to the tree. Next, who's his other children? F. F, let's go through it. F's best way of getting here was 3, like this. Now we have 8. What's better, 3 or 8? Answer 3. So we leave it alone. We don't adjust it because this is false. 8 is not a better way of getting to it, so we leave it alone. Still, the best way of getting to this node is this way. Great. Next, some other children. H is another child. H was infinity. Now we're going to make it 5. So let's write it over here. Key is 5. Parent equals E. Okay. Let's do this one. Parent here, the key was here, was infinity. Okay. Now 10 is better. So key equals 10. Parent equals E. And we're done. I'm sorry, I extracted E. Okay, we did all 4 children that are outside here. Let's just make 1, 2, 3, 4 of E. Okay, great. Now, let's go through it. Next, let's extract the minimum. Still not empty here. Let's extract the minimum. Let's extract the minimum. Let's go through it. 8, 6, 3, 5, infinity or 10? Answer 3. So let's extract f, because he's the minimum. Okay, who's its parent? He's his parent. So that's part of the tree. Okay, that's part of the tree. And now what do? We go through all the children of F. How many children does F have? F has 1, 2, 3, 4 children, but two of the children are already in the tree. We don't even talk about that. So we're just going to have to deal with these two children. Let's deal with C first. The best way to get to C was 8 by B. Okay. Question, can we do better now? And the answer is yes, we can. 5 is better than 8. So what do? We cross out the 8. We now make it 5. Okay. His best way was getting through B, but now no more. His best way is now getting F. Okay, good. I dealt with that. Let's do this one. The best way of getting to this node was 10, but now we've added this to the tree, and so 3 is better than 10, so we're going to get rid of that information. 10 is no longer relevant. 3 is better. The parent was E, but now the parent's going to be F. Okay, I'm getting a little bit bored with this, so I'm going to go a little bit quicker. Okay, let's go through it. Okay, what's the best? Now we've dealt with all of F's children, and now we extract the next one. Let's do this systematically. What's best? 5, 6, infinity, 5, or 3? Answer 3. So let's do it. The parent was F, so we're going to do this. Okay. We have to look at his children. He has only one child that's not in the tree. That's him. His best way of getting here was 5, like this. But now his best way is going to be 3. Okay, so we change it. So this was 5. Now it's 3. This was E, and now it's F. We are slowly growing this tree. Okay, great. Next, let's extract the minimum. Let's find the smallest. 5, 6, infinity, 3. Answer 3. So let's pull in 3. So his parent is F. Why did I do F? It wasn't F. It's not F, it's I. That's a mistake. I made a mistake. Okay, it's I. So let's do it. So I'm going to pull H into the tree. I'm sorry, I didn't cross this out. And then now I'm going to cross this out. I'm going to pull H into the tree. Very nice. Okay. And we now look at the children of H. H has 1, 2, 3, 4 children. But 2 of the children are already in the tree. We're not interested in that. So we're just going to look at these two children. Let's do D first because D comes before G. The best way to get to D was through E, like this. Now, question, is it better to go through 7, to go through H, like this? We just added this node. This is the extractor we just extracted. We're going through H's children. What's better, 6 or 7? Answer 6. Leave it alone. Let's do this node. You ready? The key was infinity here. This was not viewed by anything near the tree. Okay, what's better now? Infinity or 5? Answer 5. So key equals 5, parent equals H. Okay, great. Okay, we have 3 more things. 1, 2, 3. 3 more things not in the tree. Let's go through them and find the minimum. 5, 6, or 5, which one is in it? Which one should we choose? It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. But I think I want to choose this one. Okay, so let's choose it simply because it's easier. So let's choose it. The best way to get here was 5. Its parent is F, so we do this. Okay. He has no children that are not in the tree. All his children, him and him, are in the tree. We're finished with him. Great. Next, what's the best way of getting to, okay, what's the best thing? Six or five? Answer, we choose five. Okay, so we choose five. So he comes into the tree this way. His parent is H. Great. Now we look at, I have extracted G, great. Now, he only has one child. Let's look at that one child. The best way to get to D was originally here, then it was here, and now look what's the best way to get here. Through the 4, okay? Through the 4. 4 is better than 6. So let's do it, let's change it. This becomes a 4. This, his best way was E, but now his best way is G. Okay, and we are finished. Okay, we extract, everything else has been taken out. We have only one thing left, D. We pull it out. He gets into the tree like that. Okay, and we are done. We are absolutely done. Okay, let's just add up those things in the tree. 1 plus 2 is 3, plus 3 is 6, plus 3 is 9, plus 4 is 13, plus 8 is 22. Missing something. Let's do that again. 1 plus 2 is 3, plus 3 is 6, plus 5 is 11, plus 4 is 15. 20, now I get 26. No good. Let's try that again. 2 plus 3 is 5, plus 5 is 10. 11, 15, 20, I get 26. Okay, my problem was this was a 2. So this will be the 2. Okay, sorry. So now the weight is 25. Okay, great. Okay. This is called Prim's algorithm. I wouldn't say, first of all, I think Kruskal's algorithm is easier. We like greedy algorithms. We don't like to slowly build things and slowly make sure that we're not violating any rules. We like greedy algorithms that we grab what we can. Okay? But this has the intuition is much better here. You're slowly checking every single vertex to make sure you have the right one. This is very, very nice. Okay? Now, there are a lot of other graph algorithms chapter 23 and chapter 24, and there's a lot of other graph algorithms that are all over. This is the beginning. There's so many graph algorithms like that. For example, your Waze is a graph algorithm. There's so many other, you have different computer networks, you have a graph algorithm of how to interact with them, etc., etc. Graph algorithms are very, very pretty, but we're not going through that, and the book has a lot of it, and it's worth looking through them. We're not going to go through them. I want to show you a lot of different algorithms from all over. This book has 35 chapters in it. It's to 1,200 pages. We can't cover everything, but you should see some of everything. Anyways, it's two pretty little algorithms. Thanks.